toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Okay, we're back, folks. This is Larry Pesavento setting in for Tom O'Brien today. And I'm sorry to miss the first 10 or 15 minutes of the show because I was sure it was coming on at 1 o'clock Tucson time, but it was 12 o'clock. So, son of a gun, you miss one, you miss them all. Anyway, I want to start out the day by taking a look at the E-mini S&P. You notice that we have a big ABCD pattern up here at the 29.25 level. That is a really nice redrive to a top pattern. We've got some astro things that we've talked about with Norm Winsky earlier in the week, or last week, about the importance of those. And if we take a look at the NASDAQ on the hourly chart, you'll be able to see here that we are made a beautiful number up there at the 76.90 level, spot on today. So far, it's down a little bit from that level. The Dow is still strong, mainly because of Johnson & Johnson and United Healthcare, I believe. Both of those are keeping the market higher. You've got me for 2 hours here, folks. Unfortunately, I only have 15 minutes worth of knowledge, so you're going to have to call in and ask some questions because I don't know if I got that much in me at that time. We'll have to wait and see. One of the things that I was watching today, just to change the subject a little bit to show you what I do, is I am watching the price of natural gas. This is the May natural gas contract. I don't trade it often, but you'll notice that we're right here at a 1.618 expansion over the last 10 days. We've gone below it by about two ticks. We're trading just above it right now. So if it doesn't hold there, that means it's going to fail. So those are some of the things that I'm looking at right there. You're right, Mr. Bill. I don't have 15 minutes. I've got 17 minutes. Okay, one of the questions that someone asked me is, you know, how I prepare the newsletter. I do one for futures, and then I do one for the stocks. And I do them both, you know, at the same time, usually Saturday and Sunday. So we'll see. Start with silver today is actually holding up pretty well. I believe silver has actually stayed above the previous day's low as the gold has broken. That's my guess. I don't know the last price of the silver, but I believe, you know, that a silver is still holding above the 1480 level. I'm not sure in the July silver. Could someone double check that for me? Because I can't do this show and check the prices at the same time because of the it messes up with the broadcast here. 1490. You see, it's holding up relatively well. I really believe, folks, that we are getting ready for one heck of a bottom here in the gold market. We've only got what 2 days left in the week. Let's just look at this one. This is everything that you talk about with technical analysis. This goes back over the last 3 months. You'll see that. High we made up there at that 1350 level. You remember that was a 78% level on the weekly chart. We had the breakdown. We had the beautiful ABCD pattern at 1325, and our target on this is around 1255 to 1260. That's what we're looking at. 1262. We're trading at 1278 right now. We're only 16 bucks away. That's 1 or 2 days, and we've got 2 days left. We've got Wednesday and Thursday before the holiday on Friday, so we could very easily make it. Boys and girls, if you like patterns and you like gold, you have to buy that. That's a market that's come down 10 weeks now, all half of February, all of March, and half of April. So, you know, it's going to have everything going for it at those levels. Now, it might not stop there. It might just totally cascade to the downside. But when you're looking at silver, silver's actually holding up a little bit, which is quite surprising because it's been the weak sister. And even platinum down a little bit today, but you know, it's got something. You got to watch this gold, boys and girls. This is what you wait for. It's the upside down version of that NASDAQ chart that I just posted. If you drew the parallel channels in on that, you'd be able to see it, you know, pretty easily. One of the questions that someone asked me today was about the astrology part of the business that we have here. And you know, I started looking at astrology when I first started working at Drexel back in 76, August of 76. I was there through 82. In 1977, a lady came in named Mary Rivers, and she told me that she had a way of trading silver, and she didn't have any money. So I opened up a $5,000 account for her. She traded twice a month, and basically what she did is she bought silver when the moon went into Scorpio, and it had a bullish bias. Well, the problem was from 1976 all the way through 1980, that bullish bias was in the silver and gold because it was going straight up. If you followed it after that, it was only right about 6 out of 10 times. But there is some bullishness when the time when the moon is in the sign of Scorpio. We tested that much long after she left. Jimmy knew when the times were. She would put an order in, like, you know, buy silver at 7:18 in the morning, and you know, she would hold it for 2 days and then sell it. And you know, sometimes it would go against her, but by the time the moon was out of Scorpio, it was back up again, and she made money. And I paid her, oh my goodness, I think over a period of about 18 months, I paid her about $7,000, and I still owe her about $1,500, but she disappeared, you know, many, many years ago, and the statute of limitations on that ran out about 15 minutes ago, so I'm safe on that one. I don't know whatever happened to her. She's got to be in her 90s. Oh, boy, she's more than that. She's probably close to 100 now, 60, yeah. She was in her 60s, yeah, and that was 35. She's got to be 95 or more if she's still around. But that's what she did. But the real difference, I'll just to tell you how it happened. In August of 1986, Dr. Ruth Miller was having dinner at my grandmother's restaurant, Louisa's, in Terre Haute, Indiana. Louisa was my grandmother's little sister. My grandmother started it with the money and was the cook, and her other two sisters, you know, worked there too. My mother worked as a waitress there for many, many years. It was in the family for 76 years. And Dr. Ruth would eat there with her husband, John, and her son, Terry. And Terry and John were my customers when I was at Drexel during the time of 76 through 82. They were soybean farmers south in Farmersburg, Indiana. They had a big 1,000-acre farm there and beans and corn, and I did a lot of hedging for them. Of course, the old Texas hedge, long cash, long the futures. And we made a lot of money during those years, and we became good friends. John died, and Ruth moved to Illinois and remarried about 5 or 6 years later. She married another farmer. But when she was at the restaurant, she left my aunt a note saying, send this to Larry. And it was a little note that said that August beans would go off the board around, I don't know what the price was, $6.65. I wish I'd have kept the note. But I was doing expert witnessing because I was going through a divorce. I checked the prices every night. I would always keep my charts up. And I saw this little note, and by golly, when August beans went off the board, you know, she said at a certain price, and then she said, call me. Well, I wasn't very close to her. I was only saw her probably half a dozen times over the, you know, all the years I lived in Terre Haute, and she was a professor at Indiana State University. And so I called her up, and she said, I got an idea that you're going to love. It's about how Fibonacci works with astrology. Why don't you come down to Sarasota for Thanksgiving, and we'll spend some time going over this. And so I hopped on a plane, and I went down to Sarasota, Florida, to try to learn astrology. And I was there through August, September, October, November, and then I came back. We'll be right back. 877-927-6648.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, we're back, folks. I was talking about going down to Sarasota, working with Dr. Miller to learn astrology, and believe me, she had to drag me into it because I was more or less a disbeliever, even though the part that I had with Mary Rivers was good. You know, I had watched Twentyman study Gann for many years, looking at astrology, and he never came up with anything. And so I was down there just basically to take a little vacation. I was in no mood to trade because I'd gone through a divorce and we'd settled everything. And I was pretty much, I was bucks up at that time because I had split the, I had got the Drexel stock, which was quite a bit, which at that time it was. Anyway, one of the things she showed me was this top that we were getting ready to see in 1987, and she showed me all of these different things that was going on in the market. Remember, this was 1986. This was a year before any of this happened. So you can see there from 1932 to 1987 was 55 years, 21 years, 13 years, 8 years, 5 years, and 3 years. That got my attention because that was Fibonacci stuff. So I could really sort of understand that. And then we had the access to Neil Michelson at Astro Computing down in San Diego. He had been my customer at Drexel, and I had done relatively well for him in beans. And so he said, anything you want, you can have. And so we asked for all the key dates. We gave him all the key dates in the stock market and the soybeans and gold and a few others of major turns, and he would send it back on a computer run showing, you know, all the different aspects that were there, and we would match them up to see, you know, if there was something there. And sure enough, boy, these were, they were really quite quite spectacular. The one that really, really got me interested, folks, to the astrology in a really big way is the one I'm going to show you next. It's might be a little difficult. This is out of the book Astro Cycles, A Trader's Viewpoint, and I printed it out, and I hope I can, you know, you get a rough idea of what it is. But this was the bottom in the stock market in October of 1974. If you see that green arrow there, and there's a black arrow there, you see all those conjunctions that are lined up in there. That one was happening between the 21st. And the 27th of October 1974. That was the October crash. And you'll notice that the first, we see the black arrow where the chart is. That was the secondary bottom. The crash actually occurred on October the 4th. But those bottoms occurred there. Now, what happened on the other side of this, between October of 74 and December of 74, you had all those conjunctions and oppositions occurring with the different planets going between retrograde and direct motion. In other words, all of these things were coming together at that time, and that was the double bottom. The double bottom occurred around 580, as you can see. That's the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and it actually bottomed. The double bottom was in December, and it went from 580 to 26,000. I think has been the high so far, 26, 27,000. But that was the one that really, really made me believe that, wow, there's got to be something here. And believe me, I have only tiny, tiny bits and pieces of this stuff, folks. I rely on people that are a whole lot smarter than me. Let me give you their AK Steve. That's the next one I wanted to show you. This is the Pesavento Index. This is what it looks like when you statistically look like it. We'll get it up here. This is the one that Frank Tauscher from the Super Traders Almanac really loved. And this basically showed you the standard deviation of the daily aspects. If you want to know that stuff, folks, watch Mr. Steve Rhodes. He's got this down really closely on these aspects. He's got it to a really good science. So Steve alerts us when these things occur. If you have 14 or more aspects, you'll see on the far left, that means you're in the second standard deviation. You usually have 8 aspects at any particular time. That's the average. 3 or less is a standard deviation on the right side. And when you have those, you're going to have some pretty big trend changes. Why that is, I don't know. It just acts like a magnet. Frank Tauscher, who's one of the best traders I ever met, he was in the class of Amos Hostetter for sure, and also Jay Cross. But the main thing that Frank said was, he said he never found anything that timed anything better than that. And he would enter these trading contests where people traded with funny money. He always put up his own money, and the first five people, in other words, 2, 3, 4, 5, they couldn't even make 1/4 of what he made. I mean, he was amazing. One day in Tulsa, Oklahoma, he and his son, he was 59 years old, and they were standing on a street corner, and he didn't even get to finish his sentence. He died so quickly. He had an aortic aneurysm, and he died before he could get the sentence finished. Really nice man. He was one of the most generous human beings I ever met in my life. He was very religious and just a super guy, and he was really great. Really nice guy. He died in the 80s. He died in 1980. Eight, I think, 80, no, maybe 86 or 87, I believe. I know it was a long time ago. Anyway, that's mainly what we were doing, watching all these things. And I put it together in a book and, got bits and pieces. But, I have, harmonic numbers and all that stuff, all help with 20 men and all these things that occur with things like that. And then I met Shane Smolian, 5 years ago, I guess. A young man came out from Miami. And I was trying to get a book done for Wiley, and I had this young man here who was really a good astrologer, and I taught him a little tiny bit about pattern recognition. He already had a lot of information, but he took the book and basically did the work, and we published it together, and it turned out to be a pretty good book, and he's got some wonderful things in there about the speed of Mercury, because that was what George Bear used. And Bear was one of the guys that was very rich during the 30s and 40s using astrology. He had his own rail car that he would take into Chicago from Carmel, California, and he would stay there a couple months and then spend the rest of the time in Carmel. I met his daughter in 1991. She was in a nursing home in Monterey, run by one of my buddies, Jack Valeni, and I got to talk to her a little bit, and she promised me all these pictures. When she passed away, I could have them, but the attorney said they didn't exist anymore, which I didn't believe him, but that's neither here nor there. But those are some of the things. I'm still on the journey. I do believe sometimes in the near future, sometimes it's the number two thing on my bucket list, is that there'll be a segment, usually 5 minutes, maybe more, probably put on by somebody from MIT about the astro cycles of the that is the Jack Valeni of President Johnson fame. Yes, that's him. Anyway, it was really a very interesting. What was I talking about? Shut the front door. I forgot. Anyway, let's move on to I don't want to go into a lot of the astrology stuff because I don't understand it. I have a lot of these guys on here that are really good at it. I mean, Bill Meridian is terrific. Norm Winsky's good. Tim Bost is good. I mean, we've had some great guys on. Archer Crawford is good. I mean, but they're not 100%. I mean, everybody's going to be wrong all the time, folks. That's all there is to it. You're going to have to kiss a lot of frogs in this business, before you finally get to kiss the princess. That's pretty much what you're looking at. When we come back from the break, we're going to cover some more charts that I think are really important here for the coming few days, because we could be at a very, very heavy inflection point where we might even get a two-day correction in the stock market. I don't know if it'll happen in my lifetime or not, but it will somebody's lifetime. 877-927-6648.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Okay, boys and girls, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for the master himself, Tom O'Brien. I feel like I am Alex Baldwin and what's his name? Johnny Carson just went off the air, so Alec Baldwin never got any calls in, so I'm probably not going to either. But we do have a question. High-grade bonds. As you can see here, we are within a gnat's breath, and that's very, very close, of the high-grade bonds making a 78% retracement of the major head and shoulders pattern that we had way back in 2017. So everything looks copacetic in the junk bonds, but be very, very careful, folks, because the interest rate picture does not look nearly as well as we watch the Treasury bonds. We've talked about those many times. Most of you folks don't know about the newsletter, but I do this newsletter every week. And one of the things that I focus on are what I think are the main patterns. And if we look at this Treasury bond chart, you'll see the beautiful head and shoulders pattern. And, you know, you'll see that we've been down here. Here we got a situation where the AAA stuff has been going down for 2 weeks and high-grade bonds are still going up. So people are breaking the old rule written by old Mr. Bernard Baruch, is don't be concerned on the return on your money, be concerned on the return of your money. And that comes from you, from Bernard Madoff, out of the Correctional Institution of New York State. I don't know which one he's in, but he's where his vacationing will be for the next 30 years. He'll probably be paroled in the next election, but who knows. Let's take a look here at these bonds, folks. You'll notice that low we made there at 143. We just made the 61% retracement of that move from the 143 up to the high, the Fibonacci number, 150.20. Any close below 146, and it certainly looks like it wants to do that, is going to tell us that we are heading lower, and this pattern has failed, and we're looking at something very, very sinister. Remember, these topped 3 years ago, folks, when the bonds hit 177. So, you know, there's a big difference what's going on. People are chasing yield. You can see that in the junk bonds. And, you know, they are called high-yield bonds, but, you know, that's how Milken made his money. He basically said they're not junk bonds. Those are high-yielding bonds. And he was right, because during that time, during the early 70s, it was very difficult for these companies to get any financing. But when they changed the name to high yield bonds, by golly, the people came to the trough and made a lot of people rich. And of course, there are a few people during that time that were poor, but that's neither the way it is. No, Marshall, I don't have to worry about a boat ride because, well, you know, I shouldn't really say that because I'm wrong a lot and I'm right once in a while. But the joke is that if bonds get above that 177 again, I have to take a boat ride in one of Tom's boats. And, well, they're not boats, they're yachts. But I would say what I would do is I would make an excuse like the waves are too high or something like that. I just don't like being on boats, folks. I don't like small planes, and I don't like boats. A 20-man had a twin-engine plane when we were at Drexel, and I made the misfortune of letting him take me up to Utah to visit his girlfriend once up in Provo, Utah. And, oh, my God, I really thought that was it. I mean, it was in the midst of a rainstorm, and oh my goodness, I took a commercial flight back. I wouldn't go back. And he still laughs at me about that, but that's neither here nor there. Okay, let's take a look at some of these charts here. I want to show you the New York Stock Exchange Index because it's lagging the market a little bit. There's a couple things that tells us that we could be at a little bit of an inflection point here in the market. You'll see the New York Stock Exchange Index is up here around the, you know, the 129, 12,900 and change. But the one that is really interesting from my perspective, there are two of them. One is the Russell. And if you take a look at the Russell here, folks, you'll see that the Russell is lagging quite badly. We haven't even made the 78% level in the Russell, where we've exceeded it in the S&P, we've exceeded it in the NASDAQ. But the Russell is lagging badly, and the Russell had been the leader all the way up. You know, that was the first one to bottom, you know, back on December the 6th. Well, they all bottomed on December the 26th, but it was the one that came out of there very, very strong. Another one, of course, is the banking index. When we talk about money, you'll be able to see here that we're looking at the same thing, that this banking index that we're looking at stopped right at that 61% retracement. And with the action we had in Goldman Sachs on yesterday, you can see that Goldman Sachs ended up being down 7%. That has stopped exactly at the 78% level. Another reason why we could be looking at something that would be a little bit sinister, but it's still, you know, the jury's still out because we've got these other indices within a very, very short distance of making new highs. And there's no fear in the market at all. We can see that in the VIX index, that there's just nothing out there that's want to scare anybody. Well, usually it happens overnight you know, like what happened in France, but who knows? We'll see. Okay, let's keep that in mind, because there are some differences that are going on. And we're going to have Stan Harley on at the 4:30 hour, and he's going to share some of the things that he talked about on the early morning show. Had some really interesting things that looked very, very good. Ruby wants to know, talk about the worst trade I ever had. I never really had any super worst trades. I mean, I had some trades that didn't work the way I wanted it, but I never had a trade that I ever thought was my worst trade. Let me think about it. I mean, I had some really stupid trades. I mean, I was in eggs once, and I really thought that I got a report that the eggs were going to be up the limit 3 days in a row, and I went out and bought a $1,000 leather jacket. And they were down, they were down 3 days in a row. So I never wore the jacket again. I ended up giving it to a charity, to the Catholic Church there in Westlake Village for a reverse auction. Brand new, right out of Maury's, out of Beverly Hills. Just a absolutely perfect Western-style blazer. And I couldn't wear it. I got hives if I even tried to get to put it on. That's the only one I can think of, Ruby. I never really... When I lost all the money in 74, that was my best trade because it made me study the markets. What the hell did I did wrong? And once I realized that, I realized that I'd put myself in a position to do that again. So it's a main thing. If you're going to do this, do three things. Do the thing that Winston Churchill said, never, never, never give up. Okay, the second thing is develop a system that you have a belief in, whether it's moving averages or whatever it is, something that works for you, have the belief in it. And then third thing is take responsibility for your trading, and you'll make it. If you stick with this business, you're going to make it, folks. I've not met very many people, and I'm not kidding you, and I've taken as long as 3 or 4 years to train someone, but if you'll stick with it, you're going to make it. It's not that hard, for heaven's sakes. You're looking at a couple lines on a chart. If you can add, subtract, multiply, and divide, I mean, my God, it's certainly better than trying to, pick horses or, try to play the NBA playoffs or the brackets in NCAA double basketball. I mean, it's a whole lot easier than that because you're dealing on something that is relatively predictable. Dr. Andrew Lowe proved that. These patterns are predictable, and they repeat over and over again, and that's what you're really trying to do. And I don't know how I'm going to make the next hour, but I'm going to make it. I'm sure I am. With my help from Rich Anderson and Stan Harley, we'll be just fine. Tomorrow I'm going to do something special tomorrow. Because I don't get a shot at these guys very often, but we'll do this. If I could sing, then everybody would be off the air. We're going to be right back, and then at the half hour, at the hour, we're going to have Rich Anderson on, and the half hour we'll have Stan Harley.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento sitting in for Tom O'Brien, and I posted the chart for the Hang Seng Index. As you can see, we have a 3-drive to a top pattern. And we also have a 61% retracement spot on there at 31,000. And we've been up there for about a week. Haven't popped through to the upside. We certainly could, but that's certainly possible. So keep a close eye on that one. That's another reason, along with that fact that the banking index and the Russell has lagged badly, and also we're lagging in the New York Stock Exchange Index. But as you'll hear at the half-hour break, Stan Harley says the advanced decline line is certainly very, very strong still, but there's some timing things that look really interesting here with some of these. Just for the last little talk here about the gold here, I want to bring this to your attention, folks. This is the the gold-silver index. This looks extremely bullish, folks. This is so much more bullish than the gold chart. You'll notice that gold is trading substantially below the March lows, and the XAU hasn't even approached the lows from that level yet. So that means if we're coming into the 22nd of April, where that head and shoulders pattern in gold ends up, that's next Monday, you want to watch that XAU, because that's going to be a 382 retracement, and holding all those lows, if that does that, that's really bullish. You don't want to fade that one. That's like the day when we had the stock market down 600 points and Netflix was up that day, and we talked about that on the air, saying you don't want to be short that stock. And of course, the next day it gapped up 15 points on its way to go 110 points higher. So remember, let the market, give you some screaming signals when it gives them to you. Not often, but when it does, pay attention. If you've got really bullish news and that stock or commodity won't go up, and it's only got one place to go, and that's down. And if you got really bearish news and the stock doesn't go down, it only's got one place to go, and that is up. And when we come to the break here, after this first segment, we're going to be talking to Rich Anderson about some commodities. 877-927-6648.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active objective trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida, 2 p.m. Eastern time on Tuesday, 2 hours left to go in the trading day. And we got markets hanging on to positive territory, but thinly so. Dow up 26 points after being up more than 100 at one point early in the day, currently trading 26,411. S&P's positive by just 2 points right now, trading at 29.07. And the NASDAQ up 29 points, or almost 0.4% in the NASDAQ, trading at 8,005. What we get tonight, we get Netflix earnings. Checking in on the streaming giant, quite a day it's having ahead of those earnings. It just keeps trading to positive territory. Netflix up 3.8%. That's after pulling back yesterday, and quite a move, up $20 already from the low that it had made yesterday at 342, currently trading 362.26. Quite a number on those Netflix numbers. And to give you a taste on what Netflix, come on, there we go, in terms of what they expect, it's not given. There it is. So, what is Netflix going to expect? What should you expect? They're looking for quarterly earnings, 58 cents per a share, or non-GAAP earnings, 69 cents per share on revenue of $4.5 billion. The big number they're going to be looking for is about 9 million subscriber adds, with about 1.6 coming domestic, 7.3 coming international. So with that in mind, we'll jump back to the markets. We'll start it off with the Dow. As I had mentioned, markets in positive territory, but man, we had quite a slide in the morning, especially in the Dow and the S&P. NASDAQ, not so much. Dow trading 26,409, and basically at session lows that we made at about 11 a.m. this morning. NASDAQ 100, a little bit of a different story. Check out that chart. 76.78. I'm sure the NASDAQ being helped by the likes of Netflix. Currently just off the highs of 76.92 we made after 10 a.m. S&P, much like the Dow, sliding most of the day. Currently trading 29.11, just off session lows. Gold having quite a day to the downside, 1277.75. Crude oil bouncing around, trying to get above $64 again, currently trading 63.86. And the euro, US dollar, euro trading 1.1288. And also after the bell, we get Big Blue, IBM. IBM right now up about 0.6%, trading 144.77. Stay tuned, folks. We got a man, Dave White, coming up right now with the Power Trading Hour, live from 2 till 3. Special treat from 3 till 5, our man, Larry Pesavento, hosting both hours of the Tom O'Brien Show. Stay tuned, folks. Have a great Tuesday.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien. Your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Got our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for Tom O'Brien, and luckily today we have our good friend from Anderson Capital Management, Rich Anderson. Rich, are you on the line?
You bet, Larry. How are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing pretty good, my friend. We've been friends for, what, 47 years, and here we are on a radio show together. Do you want to be Johnny Carson or Ed McMahon? Which would you like to be today?
I'll be anybody. It's 60 degrees here, you know. I sent you a picture of the last of the snow. I'm sure it's going to get melted today.
Wow. Is that, Rich, is that above
really
zero?
Happy.
Is that above zero or below zero?
Above zero.
Oh, this
hey,
is a good day.
We had to windshield below zero at 60. That was no fun.
Hey, let's talk about the hogs here. I posted a chart here of the June hogs. We're up almost near $100. Is there any type of resistance at $100? It looks like we got a possible three drive to a top pattern. What are you hearing in the hog market, Rich?
Well, eventually there's going to be a deal done with China, and the amount of hogs that they've liquidated, I think it could be a temporary resistance in a pullback. In round numbers, tend to be offer resistance in any market, whether it be stocks or commodities. But I would not be at all surprised to see them, if we get a deal done with China, visiting the highs we saw a couple of years ago when we had our own swine flu problem. You know, so
yeah. What's been the historical high on hogs, Rich?
Air. Say again?
What's been the historical high on hogs?
I think it was $1.35. You know, if you took a look at a continuation monthly chart, I was talking to Cy about it yesterday, and he emailed me what I saw. You know, it's left a big, because 1 month has gone off the board, April, you know, 10th business day of the month is when an expiration occurs. So the April's gone off the board, the May's picked it up, and it's a giant gap up above highs. And our good friend, Mr. John Hill, used to call that a yum-yum.
Yeah, that's for sure. Rich, I know.
So take a look at a monthly chart, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Continuation,
yeah.
Monthly chart.
I'll have to take a look at that. I'll probably do that over the weekend. Take a look at it because I'm watching this three drive.
Or I'll email you one, and you can put it on your board tomorrow. However, you guys do that stuff.
Yeah, that'd be great. Do that. I would appreciate it. I appreciate all the information you do send me. Rich, we have a question for one of our listeners out in New Jersey about the coffee market. And I posted a chart where we were on Sunday. We've rallied a couple cents off there. Do you think there's any support at all here in the coffee at this level of, 92, 93? Does it have a chance here? Or do you know anything about coffee at all?
I know that there are many varieties of coffee that are, because of the changes, the global weather changes and where it's grown in the mountains and stuff, are not going to be able to grow in the next several years. But the honest answer about the fundamentals is no, I've never even tasted coffee. but what I do know is that any market that's gone down 60 to 70%, our good friend Rick LaRusso has researched extensively, you know, the maybe 20 to 30 markets that have done that over the years. And when they put a bottom in, the rallies aren't little ones, they're big ones. So it's on the radar list, and I'll be willing to trade it even if I've never tasted it. I want some kind of a low, little bit of rally, retest, and technical confirmation. What you taught me, that's what I'm looking for.
Yeah. Hey, Rich, how come we don't have wine and beer futures or whiskey futures? Do you know why that is?
The whiskey, the Kennedys had control of it, and then they had prohibition, and it's just too easy to make beer, and the malting barley, I used to actually trade cash malting barley, and the quality differentials, it'd be impossible to have a generic contract like number two corn.
Oh, okay. Okay, we got a question from up in the upper state of Washington about the cattle market. It looks like they've made some pretty good support here down at the 125 level. It looks like we're moving higher in April cattle.
I think so. I think these April cattle have a chance to go off the board tickling 130 again. You know, there's some basis differential that hasn't quite adjusted, but I think the boys are going to make them dance. They certainly made them dance last year. Take a look at what they did versus the Junes, and I think it can, easily happen again this year. That there's been a guy that was trying to deliver, but another guy's taking the deliveries because he's losing his packer premium, and these guys put him in a feedlot for 2 weeks and get the packer premium. So he's happy, and the other guy is, I think, not so happy.
Rich, you remember back in the late 70s when the women, the housewives, were protesting cattle when they got to, what, 90 cents a pound or something because of the inflation? You know? And they backed off for a couple of cents and then continued to go. So eventually people are going to keep eating meat until the legislation comes in that they're going to have to get rid of the cows.
Well, and, you know, just in the Minneapolis Star and Tribune yesterday, there was an article about how we're eating more meat. And as far as protein substitutes, that we would not have enough hogs to adequately take care of the Chinese if and when they start to buy. And that's part of the reason that the back-end cattle are holding it together, anticipating that maybe they'll do something. Although, as you know, the Asian palate is more towards the pork. But, you know, anticipation is there'd be some beef and some poultry also.
Okay, Rich, let's talk just a little bit here about the corn. I spoke to Doug Schaefer down in Indiana today, down there in Carmel. You know, he has got several farms over there in the Vincennes area, south of Farmersburg there along the Wabash River. And he's telling me that he's not going to get his corn crop in, if he's lucky, till about the 15th of May. He said it's so wet down there. Do you think that's going to have much of an effect over a long period of time, or what do you feel?
Well, when you plant corn, you plant a 120-day variety or 110-day variety or 100-day variety or 90-day variety. And, you know, each 10 days that you take off that variety, that the potential for that kernel of corn might be 250 on a 120-plus-day variety, but it might only be 200 on a 100-day variety and maybe only 180 on a... And I'm talking about the best crops, you know, and if there's nothing goes wrong with that kernel of corn, and if there's no major stresses, and then, of course, you have stresses, whether it be crop, disease problems, or, you know, not enough moisture, the potential for that kernel of corn in that plant goes down and down and down. So, yeah, I think it will have some impact. They'll have to switch to shorter-term varieties.
Hey, listen, thanks for joining us, Rich, and we'll have you on again at the regular show sometime next after the holiday, and have a wonderful Easter, you and the family, okay?
Thanks so much, Larry. You have a great day.
Okay, you bet. Bye-bye. We'll be right back. 877-927-6648. Larry Pesavento for Tom O'Brien.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for Tom O'Brien. We're going to do a few more commodities here, and then we're going to have Stan Harley of the Harley Stock Market Letter. He's also on the Timer Digest list. There's like 400 people trying to get those top 10 spots, and Stan is proverbial there all the time. Fortunately, we've got Kerry Szymanski here in Tucson. I think he's number one or two in the Treasury bond market. We've got Steve Rhodes was the Timer of the Year here at TFNN. We've had Tim Boston, who's always in the top 10. Arch Crawford, who's in there. So a lot of these guys are pretty smart dudes, so we'll take a lesson on what they're looking at. Let's take a look here at July wheat, folks. You'll see here that we've got a Gartley pattern forming down here at 444. We're trading around 448. We're down quite a bit today. We're down about 14 cents, which is not surprising because we're coming into this full moon here on Good Friday, and we'll be closed, of course, for all the markets, and we'll look at this thing on Sunday night and Monday the 22nd, and we want to be watching that for a potential bottom. The wheat works very nicely off of the lunar cycles, the full moons and new moons, so we want to pay close attention to it. It's very, very important from a timing standpoint, and the reason why it's important, folks, is not so much whether it's going to work or not, is the fact that it allows you to trade wheat for almost a very, very small amount. You don't have to be a wheat farmer. You don't have to own the tractors and the seed and the land and, you know, fight with the banks and stuff like that. You buy a contract at the Chicago Board of Trade, you know, for 5,000 bushels of wheat. You put your stop in of about 8 cents, $400. And if you lose that, you go to the next bank and not have to worry about it because you don't have any of the headaches that a farmer has, that's for sure. But we want to watch this wheat. It's got a really good possibility for bottoming. It really has some really, really strong things that I think would be very, very interesting. If we take a look at the continuation chart on the wheat on a weekly basis, that's the one that really makes us very interested. If you'll see here, we'll get this up here so you folks can take a look at it. This goes back, 4 years? Yeah, 3.5 years. You know, put this up so we can all take a look at it here. You know, we're down into major support area here. We're higher than we were in 2017 and also 2016, so it has some pretty good support at that level. But with that full moon coming in here on Friday, we really want to look to buy wheat on Monday morning. That's going to be the number one thing on my dance card for Monday for sure, unless something really dramatic happens with the markets, and then that might change. But I'll cover that in the newsletter over the weekend, of course, as we watch it unfold. Okay, another question that someone's asked about the commodities, and that is about the crude oil. We personally believe that crude oil is making a pretty significant top. You'll notice here as we look at the chart, you'll see, something happened. Let's just make sure that we get the old thing working correctly. There we go. You'll be able to see the crude oil with the 64 and change. That's where we're trading right now, 64.12. The 61% retracement on that is pretty much spot on in that area. And we've been here now for 4 days. So that's telling us that there's probably something of major resistance up in this area. But if we clear it, then we're looking at something that could take us all the way up to 69 and a half dollars per barrel, which is another, you know, $3, $4, $5 a barrel higher. So you're $6 a barrel higher. So, you know, it could easily take off. You saw what happened to the stock market during December. And so when these numbers fail, they go on to the next numbers, and you certainly don't want to, you know, stand in the way of that. That's a key thing, in my opinion, to really watch very, very closely. If we look at the price of the gasoline, you're going to be able to see the same type of thing. I'm having a little bit of trouble with the logistics here, boys and girls. Let's see if we can get this fixed up here. You'll notice here on the gasoline futures, we're right at the 78% level again, and so it's holding up at that level. So we're going to see whether this is going to be it in the crude oil. But made a beautiful high at 77, and we went all the way down to the 61% retracement level, and now we're coming back again. So we're going to be taking a look at it. One stock that we haven't mentioned here, this was one of the stocks from the one of these stocks that don't have any money, but they sells for a couple billion bucks. This is the Lyft that we talked about when it first came out. We have a price objective on the Lyft at 53.50, I believe. We're trading around 5,700. We got the Uber coming out here. These are these huge transportation companies that don't own any assets. They let everybody else's assets work for them, which is good, I suppose. But this price objective, after that 50% rally up to 77 bucks a share, tells us we're going to be right down to this area of around 54, 53 bucks, and that's where it should have a pretty good rally. The last rally went from 66 to 77, so we could easily see a 20% rally in Lyft. But this is a downtrending market, folks. I wouldn't buy this stuff. I'd like to sell it on a rally, but I'm not even interested in buying. I don't trade stocks, so I ought to change the subject. Any questions that anybody has? And I know, oh, wait a minute. Al's telling me that the board is all lit up. Hold, that must be because everybody thinks it's Tom's show. But Alec Baldwin here for TFNN. We'll be talking some more about some of these other stock indices that we're looking at. I wanted to show you the transportations because we are making a very significant ABCD pattern up at the 78% level, pretty much spot on. So keep an eye on that one. And those of you that go back about 100 years, like myself and a few other guys, when we used to talk about the utilities, we've definitely made some type of a double top pattern in the utility index. So we got back in the old days, Mr. Richard Russell would be screaming sell, but because of all the ETFs and all the indices and everything, you know, it's changed a lot. When we first started trading, I think we had 22 commodities, and now I think there's about 280,000 different combinations of stocks, options, and all the other things that are out there, ETFs and LEAPs and all the other stuff. I mean, it's just amazing the things that are available on these platforms that you can do with trading. And, you know, it's a lot of ways to skin a cat, folks. And like I said at the very beginning, don't ever give up if you're trying to do this, because all you've got to do is to find something that works for you, believe that it works, and then make sure you take the responsibility for your trading, and you'll be better off. And remember, the most important cycle in all of trading, folks, it's not the 18-day cycle, it's not the 2-month cycle, it's not the 200-day moving average, it's not the 400-day moving average. It's that 9-inch cycle from your left ear to your right ear. If you get that cycle right, the rest of it is a piece of cake. And trust me on that. It was really, we're going to take a look for Ruby wants to talk about platinum and palladium. Oh, palladium is going to be a little difficult, but I can do it for you. Let's get up to platinum up here, because this is one I'm watching real closely because of the gold. It's been leading, so I'm going to see if this is going to be the case. Our good friend Jim Flanagan over at GAN Educators in Santa Monica, California, he is wildly bullish on platinum. He thinks it's going up to around 1300, and you'll notice that area that we're looking at there, that we hit it exactly there at that 883. That was the low. I think we touched it again today, but we might get down to the 61% retracement at 870 if gold gets to where it's supposed to go. Ruby, I will take care of the palladium. We got Stan Harley next, so I'll take care of palladium tonight. 877-927-6648.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, we're back, folks. And in context of my usual way of keeping time, I promised Stan Harley I'd have him on at the half hour. Unfortunately, he's going to be here the next half hour, not this time. I had the time wrong, and he only lives 90 miles away from me. That's my fault. I don't know how I missed it, but I did. So I'm going to go on and just talk a little bit about what he had to talk about. I'm going to have Stan on tomorrow afternoon at this time for sure. I'll give him a call, and he'll work in. But I wanted to talk just a little bit about what he talked on the show this morning. It's a really interesting picture of the S&P, and he's looking at this April 12th to 17th clustering. These are the trading days that he's looking at. You'll notice here, 72, 144, and many of these are, you know, related to Fibonacci's. What he's talking about here is the rule of four, something with GAN. I'm not much of a GAN person, of course, because a lot of the stuff he did was a little esoteric. Even he did some astrology, but he never really did very much as far as I can say. He's back now. Yeah, let's give him a call. That would be great. Yeah, that way we can get him on today, and then he can tell us about this. But most amazing thing about GAN was the fact that he never mentioned the word Fibonacci, and he was a 33rd degree Mason, and that is really amazing. Also, right, Bill Meridian was talking about the April 16th as a possible top, and also Tim Bost was looking at it at the same time, and I believe Norm uh, Winsky, who calls it to the minute, was looking somewhere around that full moon time. So it's getting close, but whether this is it or not, we don't know for sure, but nobody knows. That's the whole thing. That's what this game was, why it's so exciting, because there's nobody out there that knows everything except God, and she doesn't trade anymore. So let's keep an eye on it. See if you get Stan on, let me know. Otherwise, hey, Stan, are you there?
I am there. Yes, indeed.
Guess what, Stan? I don't know how to tell time. I was an hour off. I don't know why. I guess I still have jet lag from 10 days ago, but it was supposed to be you're here at the right time, but the problem was I was at the wrong time, but we're ready to go. Now, listen, I posted your chart showing that your April 12th to 17th clustering. Listen, a lot of these folks, this is a Tom O'Brien show, his 2-hour show at the end of the day. So why don't you tell the folks, I mean, Stan is always in the Timer Digest, Trader of the Year type stuff. He's always in the top 10 usually, and he's been around forever. I've known him since God was a little boy. Moses and I and Stan went to school together. Anyway, that was 35 years, I think, I've known you, right? Pretty close? Yeah, easy 35.
In a while, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, let's take a look at this chart about GAN and this the rule of four. What are you seeing here with these clusters, Stan?
I'm looking at a significant Fibonacci confluence right in the present time frame. And if we get a high right in here, and maybe we saw it today, we'll know here certainly in the next day or two. But if we turn down, there will be some folks that will be screaming triple top. Triple top meaning the January high of 2018, the September-October high of last year as well, and the current one, which I think is in the making. I think the likelihood is we'll pull back for about a month, consolidate into about mid-May, and then we'll be set up to power once again higher. And then this pattern that Mr. Gann of 100 years ago called the rule of four will take place. That is to say, as a bull market advances, it makes three attempts to punch through overhead resistance, and the initial three tries all fail. And so the market then backs off, and a lot of people then are screaming triple top, it's all over. But what happens is the market consolidates below that line and then gathers some renewed momentum and then powers higher. And on the fourth attempt, breaks through that overhead resistance, and it breaks through sharply with a vengeance and rockets through and never looks back. And Larry, I haven't seen this pattern since about the 1999-2000 time period. It's been 20 years since I've seen the market do this, but I have a real sense that might be what's happening here. And if that's the case, investors might be bored here, as it were, for about the next month or so. But then we've got a back up the truck opportunity coming here in about a month's time. And when I say back up the truck, that means one needs to get aggressively long. Now, let me just back up and say, I don't have evidence yet that this is going to take place, but assuming that it does, we do get a high here, we back off, then we could be looking at a phenomenal buying opportunity in about 1 month's time. And that will be this rule of four pattern set up that should it transpire, then the bulls are got some opportunity to make some real nice coin here coming up, but probably late May, early June.
Stan, I posted the chart about your market internals, and boy, they certainly look strong, don't they, with the advanced decline line and new highs and new lows. They certainly look good, don't they?
They do, Larry. I do a lot of detailed analysis I take a peek beneath the hood, so to speak, and I look at advances and declines. I look at new highs and new lows. The advanced decline data looks, at least the advanced decline line itself, looks quite bullish. The AD line just broke out to a new all-time high. The data set on which it is based, the New York Composite, by the way, is seriously lagging the Dow, the S&P, and the NAS. It's not of imminent breakout to new highs like the Dow, S&P, and NAS are. So that gives me a little pause to refresh and to kind of reflect and think that maybe a high coming this week might not be a bad call.
That's great.
That would give the benchmark averages a chance to kind of regroup, gather some steam, and then I'd like to see the entire, all five components that make up what I call the Big Five, rocket to new highs in unison, or certainly within a few days time period. Wow. I don't see that happening right now, Larry, but in the latter part of May, if we get this back off as I'm expecting, I think we're going to have the technical.
Well, when we get close to that time, we're going to have you back on, my friend, that's for sure, because you've been pretty much spot on. And I want to thank you for joining us today, and we'll have you on probably in about 3 weeks as we get close to that area. I'd like to hear what you have to say then. Would you be able to do that for us?
Terrific, Larry. I'd be delighted.
Okay. Happy Easter to you and your bride, and I hope to, you know, get together with you maybe over the holidays and share a half a cup of cappuccino or something.
Or something. Absolutely, Larry. I look forward to it.
All right. Thanks a lot, Stan. You have a great weekend, my friend.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Okay, Stan Harley of the Harley Stock Market Letter. He's very, very been around for a long time. Does great work, and so it's really spectacular. Now we've had a question from one of our listeners about the stock of International Business Machine. Back in the old days when I was in Indiana, it was always called IBM. Meant I've been moved. Because so many people were transferred during those times. 877-927-6648.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Okay, folks, this is Larry Pesavento setting in for the master himself, Tom O'Brien. I posted a chart here of the XAU Gold Silver Index. Folks, I am very bullish gold, and I'm happen to be short right now. And I'm looking to cover, of course, a little bit lower, but longer term, when we get down, if we do get down another $20 down to that 1257 level, could go to 1247, I don't know. But keep an eye on this gold-silver index, folks. It's acting extremely bullish. It really is. It's down today, and you can see the ABCD structure that's there. That would take out the lows of March. And if we come in here on Monday and we only take that out by a little bit and don't go down very much, that's going to complete the gold pattern. It's going to complete the platinum pattern, and it might even complete the silver pattern. Pay attention to that, folks. On page 221 and 222 of the book, Profits in the Stock Market by Harold McKinley Gartley, he said, buy those ABCD corrections in a bull market, and this would be one. And if you look at this really closely, from February through April and March and April, you got another ABCD there. You see the light gray, that would be point C, and then you got another D pattern coming down there at around 73. That's about a buck and a half. Per share lower in the XAU. So watch this very, very closely. This is what I do every weekend, is to go over all these to line up what we think the trades are coming up. And we're going to have a big one this coming week because of the way everything's lining up in these metals. It looks quite enticing. Hey, they might not work, but that happens all the time. You know, you don't want to get involved with your losses. Ruby, you asked the question about, I don't really remember my losses, dear. I forget those as soon as I can. I mean, it's, it's just something you have to do. If you've ever had a kid, a child, and you want to try to get them to ride a bike, you know, if they keep falling over, you don't say, hey, stupid, get on the bike and try again. You just keep encouraging them. And over the period of years, I kept encouraging myself, saying, yeah, you can do this. Took me a long time and had to bang my head on the table a few times because I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer. But, I was born at night, but it was early in the evening, so there was still sun out. And so, anyway, let's watch this one really closely because this could be an easy way to enter the gold market if we are correct. And we're not saying we are yet, but when we get down to that level, if we do, we're going to be able to watch it really, really closely because it's going to be a really nice setup for a wonderful pattern, much like we were looking at when we were in the worst that one on December 26 on the stocks. Was extremely difficult, extremely easy because so many things hit those numbers, starting with the banking index and all of them. I mean, the NASDAQ, the S&P, the Dow Jones, all of them hit major Fibonacci numbers. So this won't be quite that exciting, but it should be exciting if we get there. But this is acting very bullish right now, and a little bit more weakness to take out those March lows. Would be nice, much like you looked at those lows in November last year. We made a double bottom between September and November and then had a big rally. So this is something you want to pay attention to. And I don't trade stocks very often, and I won't trade this. I'll be trading the futures themselves because gold is one of the things that I like to trade most. And I like to trade all of them, but gold has been very, very good to me through the years. But this is really set up nicely for a potential bullish pattern in the gold. And silver's still acting pretty good. Now, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see if it's going to do it. Now, Ruby asked about the palladium, and I'm going to try to do that for her because she's one of our star pupils here, and we want to get this up here. Now, palladium is PA. I've never traded it. I hadn't even started looking at it until, about a month or so ago. And we're still in a down move here in the palladium. Let's get this up here. Let's do the weekly chart here for you so we can see where we are. Yep, this is where we are. You can see that 382 retracement. Give me 1 second, and I'll post it into the room, and we can chat about it a little bit. Because on this last rally here, you'll notice that we only made a 382 retracement up there at 1405. We're now trading at 1331. That's going to take us down to those old highs at 1150. And if you get palladium down to 1150, you're going to have to look at that very, very closely, because those are the old highs from 2018. It's also going to be at a 50% retracement, and it'll be an ABCD pattern from the high that we made on this weekly chart, you know, way back in the third week in March. So really strong support at 1150 in the palladium. So we'll watch that. I don't know anything about palladium, folks. I'm not even sure how to spell it. So never traded it, but it's very, very thin. I mean, I think the open interest on it is just a few thousand contracts. So it's not for the faint of heart, and I don't like stuff like that. I like when you got some players in there that at least you know you're going to be able to get filled without too much trouble. And on these, I've heard that you get slippage here, 40 or 50 bucks an ounce. That's $1,000. So I don't want to get involved with that. But that's what the chart looks like. I wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole, even if I had a 10-foot pole. Anyway, that's what we're watching here in the thing. Boy, time is going fast. 2 hours. Shut the front door and raise the rent. Okay, now tomorrow afternoon, I had a guest. Who was it going to have tomorrow afternoon? Arch Crawford. Arch should be here tomorrow to chat with me. And then tomorrow I'm going to do something special. Tomorrow I'm going to go down memory lane, and I'm going to go over the history of how I got started in this business, where I got to, how I bumped around, the silly mistakes that I made, some of the smarter moves that I made, and it's hopefully you'll learn from it. I'm not going to write an autobiography. I just don't have the energy anymore. I've got a lot of notes and stuff over the years that I've kept. I'm going to go over those, but I'm going to do that tomorrow afternoon. We'll cover the markets, of course, because it's Thursday, the last day of the week this week, so we want to see what's coming up for Monday. But I want to spend some time. I've had several emails saying, you know, how did you get started in this, and you know, why did you like it, and all that stuff. And you know, it's been fun. I mean, God, I can't believe that God blessed me with something here. I'm, you know, running into 8 furlongs, boys and girls. You know, I've been around for a long time. You know, I've been doing this for 7 decades. I started in the 59. That was the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. Now, yeah, this is my 8th decade, believe it or not. So we'll see how this ends up. But anyway, that's what we're going to be watching tomorrow as we go through some of these. Remember, the bond market, I believe, has topped. I really believe that 150.20 is not going to be violated anymore, and pay attention to that. And as I posted, the very first chart today was that natural gas, and we want to watch that very closely. This is the May contract, and we are setting right at that 1.618 level. If you can hold it tonight, it's got a chance, so watch it. It's I love those 1.618s. That's the last ring of the old Fibonacci spiral, so pay attention to natural gas. It's got a chance in here. Also, the euro. The euro is still trying to hold up here. This 113 level is a little below that right now. It's doing a relatively good job so far. I don't think anything will happen until after next week because of the holiday coming up tomorrow. Today's Wednesday. Yeah, tomorrow. And, oh, wow, today's only Tuesday, isn't it? Shut the front door and raise the rent. So I won't even be on Thursday. Wow, I got that messed up too. Boy, don't ever give an Italian a clock. He'll mess it up. Anyway, we will talk about the history of the stuff tomorrow. Just for some reason, I never get a chance to do it. 877-927-6648.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help
help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Okay, folks, we're winding up the show here for Tom O'Brien. The stocks, Dow Jones was up on the day. S&P looks like it was about unchanged. NASDAQ down just a little to up a little. I guess it's up, so not much going on. We talked to Stan Harley, the possibility we might have a little bit of a top in here, but longer term, it certainly does look bullish, especially when you look at the advanced decline line and the new highs to new lows. The bonds, I believe, have made a major top. I believe the U.S. dollar is getting ready to have a big move through the eyes of the euro. If we get the euro below 112 again, I believe we're going to start seeing the dollar accelerate rapidly and the euro drop rapidly. If we get the euro above the 114.50 level, the euro looks like it could go a lot higher. So we're in this really tight trading range. I don't think anything's going to happen until next week, especially with the holiday coming in. But the euro has just been here now for 10 days. We should have a little bit of a pullback, and then we'll see if it's going to have legs. But we could easily go down one more time and get below that 111.60 area. You could be looking at something pretty serious on the downside in the euro if it does that. We've been going down since September. You can see the lower highs, 61%, 78% spot on as you go through. So it follows the Fibonacci summation sequence quite nicely. And if you match it up with the number of days up, number of days down, looking at ABCD patterns, 135s, Gartley's, butterflies, I mean, it gives you a little bit of an edge, and that's what you're trying to do. The question is, do you have the responsibility to take that trade and be responsible for it? You can't blame it on anybody else. I'd like to, but they don't let you do that. So keep an eye on this. It's got a real chance here to have a pretty significant move. It could go either way, no question about it. I don't believe it'll be until after what happens Easter, and then we will see what next week brings. I don't see any super big cycles here for the next part of the week. So we'll have to rely on what we're looking at here So that's what we're paying attention to. So 877-927-6648.